Welcome to MLT online classes. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about menstrual cycle. Okay, so what is the definition of menstrual cycle, students? Menstrual cycle can be defined as cyclic events that take place in a rhythmic fashion during reproductive period of a woman's life. So it is defined as a cyclic events that takes place in a rhythmic fashion during reproductive period of woman's life, which will start at the age of 13 to 15 years and ends by age of 45 to 50 years. So the period cycle will come, it is a rhythmic events which will happen within a woman, for which will start at the age of 13 to 15 years, and it will stop at the age of 45 to 50 years. And the starting stage is called as menarche. The first period is called as the puberty. First period is called as menarche, which happens at the age of 13 to 15. And the event and the time where the menstrual cycle stops, and that is called as menopause. Menopause means no more stopping of menstrual cycle. Stopping of menstrual cycle is called as menopause, whereas the first menstrual cycle is called as menarche. So this is the simplest definition of menstrual cycle. Then I will discuss few more introduction, then we can discuss detail. Okay, so menstrual means, so at the first stage, what happens, students? In the first stage, woman bleeded. So her period, first day of period. From first day of period, or at the age of 13 to 15, it is called as menarche. So she got a first period. After that, first 14 days, woman will see from the day of period until fourth day, woman will be in bleeding stage, and this is called as menstrual phase. Okay, so during this period she will bleed a lot. After fourth day, her ovary will redevelop, and at the 14th day she will release a ovum into the abdominal cavity. So the ovary will release a small ovum into the abdominal cavity at the age of 14th. Okay, from 14th till the day of 28 days. Okay, until 28th day, uterus will be in growth. And after 28th day, if this ovum is not fertilized, means it will go to menstrual phase and it will do once again. The cycle will repeat. So this is called menstrual cycle. So it has two important phases. One is pre-ovulatory phase and post-ovulatory phase. So the events of menstrual cycle can be divided into two broad categories. One is changes in the ovary and changes in the uterus. So what happens to the ovum? What happens to the ovary and what happens to uterus during menstrual cycle? Okay. So in the ovary, before release of ovum, it will undergo a process called oogenesis. Oogenesis. So oogenesis happens from the after 4th day of period to the 14th day. That period is called as oogenesis. Also it is called as pre-ovulatory phase. Pre-ovulatory phase. After releasing of ovum, this phase is called as post-ovulatory phase. Post-ovulatory phase. Okay, so these are the events happens in the ovary. Then what happens in the uterus? So in the beginning, what happened? Uterus shedded blood, right? And the first stage of uterus is menstrual phase. It has a first phase, which is menstrual phase. So in menstrual phase, what happens is uterus will shed all the blood vessels, blood into the outside. So this is menstrual phase. After shedding the blood, uterus will start developing a new blood vessels within the uterus. It will have a new blood vessels, and this phase of uterus is called as proliferative phase. Proliferative phase. So this proliferation of new blood vessels is mediated by a hormone which is estrogen. Estrogen mediates production of new blood vessels within the ovary, okay, within the uterus, okay. After that, after proliferative phase, if the woman secretes a ova, means these blood vessels will start secreting mucus within the uterus, and that phase is called as secretory phase. Secretory phase. So secretory phase is mediated by a hormone called prostagen will mediate the secretory phase of the uterus. So these are the overall phases of menstrual cycle. So menstrual cycle has two important events: ovarian changes and uterine changes. In ovarian changes, we have two important. One is pre-ovulatory phase, and second one is post-ovulatory phase. Whereas in uterine changes, we have three phases: menstrual phase, then we have proliferative phase, then we have secretory phase. Proliferative phase of the uterus is mediated by estrogen, whereas secretory phase of the uterus is mediated by progesterone. So let me discuss about ovarian changes in the menstrual cycle in detail. Okay, so I'm going to erase these things. Just draw this diagram, okay, everyone. Now we have two important key role players in this menstrual cycle. Two important hormones. First hormone is estrogen, and second hormone is progesterone. So how these two hormones regulate menstrual cycle, we can see. Before that, we need to introduce one more gland, which is also called as master gland, that will regulate all the hormones in the body. What is that, students? If you are smart, you may say pituitary gland. If you are over smart, you can say hypothalamus. Okay, so this is pituitary gland, and this part is called as hypothalamus, and this is pituitary gland, also called as master gland of the body. Okay, now this, I'm going to discuss about ovarian cycle. First, this hypothalamus will release a hormone called gonadotropin releasing hormone. GH releasing hormone. It will release a hormone called gonadotropin releasing hormone. So this gonadotropin releasing hormone will secrete into the anterior pituitary gland. Now this anterior pituitary gland will secrete two important hormones. Okay, what are those? Luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. LH, luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. So what these two hormones did, I will discuss here. So the ovary will, within the ovary we have follicles, right? Ovarian follicle. So this is ovarian follicle, and ovarian follicle has three important structures. One is outer layer of an ovarian follicle is made up of a cells called theca cells. Whereas within the ovarian follicle, we have a cells called granulosa cells. And the middle one is obviously ovum, which contains the genetic material. Okay. So theca cells, granulosa cells, and ovum. So forget about ovum. Let us focus on theca cells. So what happens here is, in the presence of luteinizing hormone, these theca cells will produce a substance. That substance is called as androstenoidin. So theca cells of the ovarian follicle will secrete androstenoidin in the presence of luteinizing hormone, which is secreted by the anterior pituitary gland. Anterior pituitary gland secreted luteinizing hormone, which in turn with the help of gonadotropin releasing hormone. So gonadotropin releasing hormone will stimulate the anterior pituitary gland. Anterior pituitary gland will release luteinizing hormone. This luteinizing hormone will affect on the theca cells, and these theca cells will produce androstenoidin. Okay. Now, meanwhile, these granulosa cells will get influenced by the follicle stimulating hormone. Follicle stimulating hormone will be affected on the granulosa cells, and these granulosa cells will secrete an enzyme, and that enzyme is aromatase. Granulosa cells of an ovarian follicle will secrete an enzyme called aromatase. These granulosa cells will secrete aromatase with the help of follicle stimulating hormone. Follicle stimulating hormone is secreted by the anterior pituitary gland. So, under the influence of FSH, granulosa cells will secrete aromatase. This aromatase will act on the androstenoidin. It will cleave androstenoidin, which is secreted by the theca cells, into estrogen. Actually, it is not estrogen. To be precise, it is 17-beta-estrodin. So, this 17-beta-estrodin is nothing, is a precursor of estrogen. Okay? Keep in mind, this is how estrogen is produced by the ovarian follicles. So, first the hypothalamus will secrete gonadotropin releasing hormone. This gonadotropin releasing hormone will go to the anterior pituitary gland, and anterior pituitary gland will secrete two hormones, luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. This luteinizing hormone will in turn acts on the theca cells of the ovarian follicle, and these theca cells will produce androstenoidin. Meanwhile, follicle stimulating hormone will secrete aromatase with the help of granulosa cells of the ovarian follicle. This aromatase will cleave androstenoidin into 17-beta-estrogen, which is the estrogen. So what this estrogen did is, this estrogen will prevent the release of negative feedback, release of FSH. So FSH production will be inhibited by the estrogen. Then this graafian follicle will, sorry, this ovarian follicle will start growing. It will start growing in size. Okay, ovarian follicle will start growing in size. Then what happens is, this ovarian follicle will affect on the, I'm going to erase this one. So gradually within the blood, estrogen levels will be drastically increased. So estrogen levels will drastically increase. Okay. So because this ovarian follicle itself secreting so much estrogen, now it has the capability of producing estrogen, and this estrogen will in turn once again acts on the hypothalamus. So this is pituitary gland, this is hypothalamus, and this estrogen acts on hypothalamus to release more gonadotropin releasing hormone, and this, since more gonadotropin releasing hormone releases, that in turn stimulates the anterior pituitary gland, and anterior pituitary gland will secrete once again luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. Okay, so this increased, that in turn increases the estrogen. Okay. So this is increased estrogen, what happens to the ovary means, so this is the ovary and this is the follicle. Follicle will start growing enormously, and follicle will become so big that follicle will release the ovum. So ovum will be released from the follicle in the presence of increased estrogen. This increased estrogen will increase the blood vessels to the ovary, and these blood vessels will release ovum by a process called ovulation. So this is how estrogen will act on the ovary to release ovum from the ovary. So this is the mechanism of estrogen on ovary. Okay, so now I'm going to erase this thing. And also, now see students, this is very important. We already know this estrogen also acts on the uterus. Okay, so what is the first stage of uterus, students? In the menstrual cycle, first it will bleed, right? In the day zero of period cycle, uterus will bleed the blood, shed the blood for first 1 to 4 days, and that is called as menstrual phase, right? Menstrual phase of uterine changes. Then the second phase of the uterine changes is proliferative stage. That means uterus will develop more blood vessels within the uterus, right? Proliferation of new blood vessels is called as proliferative phase, and these new blood vessels form due to estrogen. This estrogen also helps uterus to form more blood vessels. Okay, so it will increase the blood vessels, also it will increase the thickness of endometrium. It will increase the thickness of endometrium. Also, it will increase the mucus production. It will increase the mucus production within the uterus. And this is the second stage, proliferative stage. As I already stated before, proliferative stage is mediated by the estrogen in the uterine cycle, right? So this estrogen will increase the proliferation of new blood vessels within the uterus. Meanwhile, what happens to the now ovum released into the blood, and this leftover empty body will convert to something. What is that, students? This empty shell is called as corpus luteum, right? And this corpus luteum will in turn becomes albicans, corpus albicans. So what this corpus luteum will do? This corpus luteum will start secreting new hormone, which is progesterone. Progesterone levels within the blood will be increased because this corpus luteum started secreting progesterone. Meanwhile, the estrogen levels will get decreased because already this after ovulation there is no more follicle. So estrogen production will be decreased. Now estrogen production will be decreased and the progesterone levels within the blood vessel increase. And this progesterone, which in turn inhibits the gonadotropin releasing hormone. If there is no, what happens? It will inhibit the gonadotropin releasing. That means without gonadotropin, the follicle cannot grow. Growth of follicle is mediated by FSH and LH, right? Luteinizing hormone. Now these two hormone supply will be inhibited by progesterone. Also progesterone will induce secretion of more mucus within the uterus. So progesterone will increase secretion of mucus within the uterus. So that is, this stage of uterus is called a secretory phase of uterus. The final stage is secretory phase of uterus. So in secretory phase of uterus, progesterone will increase the mucus production within the uterus. Also, it will increase the thickness of endometrium. Increase the thickness of endometrium. Also, it will increase the chance of fertilization. Chance of fertilization. Okay students, then what happens after is, now the ovary was ovary released ovum, and this ovum, release of ovum is mediated by estrogen. After that, progesterone will enhance the further development of uterus. Meanwhile, if this ovum, if the female didn't get the sperm, means what happens, means this corpus luteum will be converted to corpus albicans, and this corpus albican will secrete something called inhibin, and this inhibin will prevent the supply of progesterone. If there is no progesterone, means there is no more Okay, this inhibin will inhibits both progesterone and estrogen supply. If there is no progesterone and estrogen, means there won't be new blood vessels and all these blood vessels will shed, leading to a period menstrual bleeding. If the progesterone levels inhibited, means that leads to the bleeding and the cycle once again starts. So that enters into the uterus, will enter into menstrual cycle. After menstrual cycle, once again the graphene for the ovary will start secreting estrogen and it will be cleaved into progesterone. Entire cycle will replete. So this is menstrual cycle in a nutshell. If you have any notes, you can ask me in the class, students. That's it. Thank you.